To the north of Ant Paradisica lies the great green plain of Antamana, which is full of all kinds of strange insects who will not miss a single opportunity to kill and eat the weaker one among them. But out of all of them, there is a particular insect among them who is a master assassin and a merciless killer, revered and feared by all. This is her story. The Green Lady Assassin Wasp is out for a kill. It is digging the muddy floor where deep underground lies the prey of this merciless assassin wasp. This agile and sleek assassin, who is notorious in the ant world as the jewel or emerald wasp, is very efficient in digging into the nest of his victim. And so the green emerald assassin gradually begins to pull out all objects of defense of his prey. It continues to walk tirelessly, not stopping even for a while, removing all the obstacles in his path, one by one at a time. When the emerald assassin realizes that the last defenses of his target will soon be down, it begins to walk with heightened energy and speed. But after toiling so much, the emerald assassin soon finds out that this burrow of his prey is empty. Now this must have been really frustrating for the emerald assassin. However, without wasting any more time, she walks away in search of other hideouts of her prey. Oblivious to all of this, a feral ant army is hunting termites nearby. And unlike for the emerald assassin, this day has proven to be a lucky one for them, for they have been able to catch a fat, juicy termite alid, which will provide the much needed protein for the queen and the growing young larvae. The legs of this termite alid is still moving. It looks like it is still alive. Maybe it was out for a nuptial flight last night. Don't know whether it is male or a female. But if she is a fertilized female, then this is a sad end of what would have been a last thriving colony of termites in the future. 2 days later, in another part of the jungle, a Tetraponera rufonigra soldier is walking near a big hole in the ground. It looks like this Tetraponera rufonigra has just been in an ant war and it is searching for something. It moves towards the hole with a determination to enter inside. But just then, out of the dark big hole emerges the shiny green emerald assassin. The green killer is again out for her hunt out here. And then suddenly, something emerges out of the hole. It immediately starts to run away for its life. But the emerald assassin goes after it ferociously and soon has the poor creature in her grip. It is soon stung and left behind for the venom to have its effect. But the prey, which is a poor fat cricket, is still moving. So the green emerald assassin comes running after it and then using its super last mandibles, at first it subdues the last cricket and then it stings it again, inserting several drops of its deadly venom inside the body of its unlucky victim. The job is done, but the emerald assassin has to ensure that the venom does not kill the cricket. A dead cricket will not be of much use for her in this case. But 1,000 years of evolution has programmed the instincts of this wasp, which will automatically guide her not only as to how and where to sting for the perfect paralysis of its prey, but also as to how to avoid the formidable jaws of this cricket while getting its job done. The long jumping legs of the cricket are already paralyzed, but the upper parts of the cricket is still moving. So the next target of the emerald assassin is to sting and get the upper legs and the head of the cricket paralyzed. Getting into the right position, the emerald killer goes for the perfect hole, and then with great precision, it at first stings and gets the forelegs of the cricket paralyzed, and then next, it goes for the head of the cricket. The paralyzing job is complete, and so the emerald assassin begins to carry away the paralyzed cricket towards its final destination. But the surface is rough and full of obstacles. So even for the strong emerald assassin, dragging the heavy body of the cricket through this rough surface is not easy. The emerald assassin has to use all of her strength, but she ultimately succeeds in dragging away the paralyzed body of the cricket. After reaching a certain point, the emerald assassin leaves the cricket on the floor and walks away, maybe to track the way ahead towards its destination. But soon it returns back and again begins to drag the body of the cricket towards the dense grasses. This is the same hole from which the cricket had emerged. So the Emerald Assassin is going to use the nest of the cricket itself to body the paralyzed cricket alive. Of course, with its eggs, which will soon develop into larvae and eat it alive. But no one should forget that this is the ants' kingdom. And so, all kind of ants start coming towards the hole, maybe drawn by the smell of the paralyzed cricket. But the feral ants are walking so close to the hole, and it looks like the whole army of feral ants are here. And still more are coming this way. Many of the feral ants are also seen going inside the hole. And so soon, we see the emerald wasps coming out of the hole and running away towards the grasses, carrying away the cricket with it. Now, it is not that the Emerald Assassin is afraid of the tiny feral ants, but even if she chases them away initially, the ant may soon return back when she is gone and dig out and eat both the cricket and her egg. The Emerald Assassin cannot take such tricks. So she hurriedly carries away the cricket far away from there and soon reaches the boundary of Ant Paradisica. Here she rests the cricket on the ground and goes in search of a suitable hole where she can safely hide the cricket and lay her eggs on it. However, while the Emerald Assassin is away, the smell of the cricket has attracted all kinds of ants towards it. And so when the Emerald Assassin returns back, she has to fight the angry Tetraponera Rufonigra soldiers to claim back her kill. Well, the Tetraponera Rufonigra soldiers are of no match for this deadly assassin. So after defeating the hungry ants, the big green wasps hurriedly carries away the paralyzed cricket towards the hole she has discovered in the vicinity of Ant Paradisica. It looks like the Emerald Assassin is well aware of all other ants present in Ant Paradisica, especially the Godzilla ants. So she hurriedly pulls the paralyzed cricket into the nearby hole. Though now she is inside the hole with the paralyzed cricket, the Emerald Assassin is still alert. She keeps on carefully checking the movements outside the hole to find out if any intruder or any threat is out there. After making sure that no enemy is outside, the Emerald Assassin slowly climbs out of the hole and begins to carefully scan the adjoining area. Finally, when she is sure that the hole is secure, she quickly starts to throw loose mud into the hole. She walks tirelessly for several minutes, often entering the hole and probably adjusting the position of the cricket on which by now she has laid her eggs. After several minutes of hard work of the Emerald Assassin, not even a single trace of the hole remains on the ground. After successfully completing its mission, the Emerald Assassin leaves the place. But this is not the end. It is just the beginning of a new mission for her.